Hi, I'm David Avrin with the Customer Experience Advantage. I want to ask you a question. Do I have your undivided attention or do I have your divided attention? I'll tell you why that's really important to your business in a second. So you are a multitasker. You take pride in being able to work on multiple projects or issues at the same time. People boast all the time about what great multitaskers they are. But is that really a positive thing? Certainly not when it comes to your customer experience. Your clients and customers don't admire all that you are able to do as they engage with you. They want you to focus on them and their questions or problems or purchase. How often do people really give us their undivided attention? How often do you gift that to other people, the people you're working with or working for? Now listen, we've all had conversations with people who are also checking on their phones, looking at their watch, typing on their computers, or having simultaneous conversations with others while we're trying to get their attention. Some will even look past us to see if there's somebody more important or more interesting behind us or somewhere else in the room. Listen, we can tell. We can always tell. We have a hard enough time doing one thing well, let alone several. Open door policies were created with the best of intentions, and they sound nice, but they rarely work in actual practice. You're basically inviting people to come in and interrupt you at any time, regardless of the fact that it might take you 10 minutes to refocus on your work after they leave. Divided attention rarely creates great work, while focus often does. When you're working with clients or customers or coworkers, how often are you trying to do other things at the same time? Or are you working to make them feel like the most important person in the room or on the phone? We can tell when we have half of your attention. We can always tell. Now, there are times when our young children will take our cell phone out of our hands, grab our face, turn it towards them as if to say, look at me, pay attention to me. When I get a call from a client and I'm in the middle of something on my desk, I'll often say to them, can you give me a quick 30 seconds to get something off my plate? I want to give you my undivided attention. And they always say, sure, of course. The alternative is trying to finish up what you're doing while you're taking the call. And then they feel like they're getting half of you, as you say a lot of, yeah, listening with half an ear. Can you think of scenarios where your divided attention might make your prospect or customer or coworker feel as if you don't value them, like you're going through the motions? Think of all the times when you might be engaging a prospect, a vendor, a coworker. It could be in the office, on the phone, or even over lunch. Is your phone on the table, or even in your hand? How many times do you look at it while you are together? You may think you're being subtle, but your customers or prospect are likely feeling undervalued, or worse yet, they're feeling disrespected. My brilliant colleague, Neen James, reminds business audiences that when you pay attention, attention pays. Here's why you do it. Most people multitask because they can, and they believe that their job requires it. But when it interferes with your success, or when conversation is one of the elements that you're trying to juggle simultaneously, it doesn't work. Here's why we hate it. Because we don't want to repeat ourselves. We don't want to worry that you didn't get the details or our intention or our order correct. We also don't want to feel as if something else in that moment is more important than our conversation, our question, or our concern. Here's a better approach. Be conscious of when the situation dictates attention, undivided attention. There's a difference between juggling three projects on deadline and juggling a client conversation with a call from home, a colleague walking by, or even a social media alert on your phone. Be aware of all the things that might distract you in a conversation and commit to putting them aside or at least out of sight. Lean in, focus on their face, listen to their words, and don't just wait for your turn to talk. Remember, pay attention and attention will pay. Just saying.